Why do you play Call of Duty? A franchise that's well over a decade old. Some people say it's just the same thing every year. Other people say it tends to be different every year. But why do you play? Why do you continue to power up your console or turn on your PC and play Call of Duty? Welcome to the channel, everybody. That's the question I asked my community today over on the Team Chaos Discord. If you guys want to join the Discord and get involved in these videos, definitely do so. And I said, why do you still play Call of Duty? And we got a lot of different remarks. So we are going to go over all of them. And in the comments, you tell me, why are you still playing this game? But before we do that, I have something really cool for you. Today's COD history video is powered by IO Gear and their Keymander 2 Switch. They were also nice enough to send me a care package. We got the Momentum Pro Gaming Mouse. We've got the Pro X keyboard, but it's all about the Keymander 2. You can use a keyboard and mouse in place of your controller on anything. Xbox Series X, S, Xbox One, PS4, Nintendo Switch, it doesn't matter. You can also share a keyboard and mouse with up to 3 PCs and game consoles with hotkey switching. But that's not the coolest thing. The coolest thing is the crossover function, which allows you to swap your controllers between a PS4 and an Xbox One and a Switch. If you want to play your Xbox with a PS controller, you can do it. If you want to play your PlayStation 4 with a Switch controller, you can do it with this. Guys, with the push of the button, you can swap between multiple systems. I mean, you can play how you want to with a keyboard and mouse. Super easy to set up. It has an iOS and Android app. You can remap the keys. You can do macro features, everything. Super easy to dial it in and set it all up. You guys, check it out. The link is at the top of the description. Let me know if you grab a Caliber Gaming Keymander 2 by IO Gear. Heck, let me know if you bundle it up with a pro mouse, a keyboard, whatever else your little heart desires. The link is at the top of the description. Okay, guys, we're going to call this a top 15 because I wanted to showcase as many Team Chaos community members as I could. So we're going to start off with Trap Vita. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. Because it's nostalgic and hoping that the next game will be better than the last. I truly, truly believe this encapsulates all of us. We hope that the next game will be better than the last. It's this crazy, crazy ecosystem and cycle that we go through every single time. We get hyped up in April through May or June for the next COD. It gets here and we're like, then we get hyped up for the next one. That's a really, really good answer. Next up, ChaosX Nacho. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. To get the early game grind and the satisfaction of unlocking and trying out all the new guns and getting them to max level. I agree with this. But is that starting to get a little stale? Is that starting to get a little old? Let's face it. Multiplayer 6v6 is possibly on its way out. I mean, you have Warzone and you have Battle Royale, and now it looks like Zombies is going to become its own standalone experience in the future. Where does that leave multiplayer? Because in the golden age of COD, it was mostly about multiplayer with everything else kind of being side stuff. Next up, Aussie number 2. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. Simple to prove you're better than your friends. I agree. To show your friends you're better, but you're really using the most broken guns. Okay. To be a part of a loving community. Yes. There is a loving community. I mean, look at the Team Chaos community. To watch Jimmy and have ideas of what he's talking about. Good answer. Next up, Sub2ALX. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. Because COD 4 was so good. Okay, we're going way back. And hype the next release into oblivion. Most of us played COD 4 too much at that time, and it grew a habit on us. I still play Warzone to think about the Golden Age, which COD 4 established, and was the reason why we have so many FPS shooter games today. You're right. COD 4 was the catalyst for so many things, not just in Call of Duty, but the FPS world altogether. So what Sub is saying is COD 4 was so good that it made us get attached for the next decade. Jacob134. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. Trolling. Especially when you have a full squad with shovels and stuns running around hardpoint shipment COD Mobile. Yeah, people like to troll. It used to be a lot bigger. I remember getting a group of my friends together in Black Ops 2, and we would riot shield and shock charges. It was a good time. I haven't trolled in many, many years, but if you go back and look at the history, there was a time where your boy, well, let's just say chaos in Minnesota burns. We'll leave it at that. Next up, Mr. Price says, hashtag Chaos Top 10. I still play because one day I hope we have the play style of the Golden Age era, but I still get disappointed. I can relate to this. I'm a sucker for the Golden Age era. I talk about it all the time. Some people want me to quit talking about it, but I can't. It was what kind of formulated me when it comes to Call of Duty. It also kind of created this. It created this brand, this chaos, this team chaos, this platform. It's been a part of my life for over a decade, and it's hard not to go back and have wishful thinking for the old good Golden Age Wild West era. Yeah. Joe Mac Menace. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. I think the main reason I still play Warzone, even though it's completely broken, is because I'm not willing to let the series go. It still has potential. I just wish Activision was a bit more active with the player base and stopped monetizing it so hard. Sorry for the horrible pun. They monetize it, but they're definitely monetizing it in a much better, cleaner way than they did 2 or 3 years ago. Let's put that out there. And yes, it's the whole golden carrot dangling because Warzone has so much potential. Warzone's an amazing game. I have a ton of memories with Warzone. Yes, there's lots of issues, but isn't it that way every single year? There has to come a point where maybe we just accept it for what it is, hope for the best, and either enjoy it or don't. I get it, though. I get it. It has a ton of potential, and if they could get past all the problems of the hacking and everything, it could be even better. Alex Kitch 11. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. In order to take full advantage of the meta OP weapons before they are actually nerfed, if they ever are. There's actually a huge community for this. And what he's saying is, when an update comes or a patch comes, you instantly grab on to the meta. What are the meta guns? What are the OP guns? And then you go just to town with these guns until they get patched. A lot of people don't like that. Other people, that's why they play the game. Except like Alex Kitch right here. I'm not hating. You play it for why you want to play it. I mean, we all play the game for different reasons. So his is to take full advantage of those OP weapons. Diamond Deancey. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. The toxicity wars. You always know that there's going to be at least two people screaming nonsense at each other at the end of a match, and all you can do is laugh unless you are the one screaming, in which case you get your intervention ready. But here's the problem. I'm not promoting toxicity, but I would be lying if I said it wasn't part of what made the Golden Age what it was, because you had the open mic chats. You were able to make those connections good, bad, ugly, negative, positive, and that's kind of what people looked for. You don't have that anymore. You have skill-based matchmaking. You have lobbies that are dissipated at the end of each match. You can't really make those connections good, bad, ugly, positive, negative otherwise, because the matchmaking is completely different right now. So to me, that's a Golden Age thing, the toxicity wars, for sure. The dedicated medic healer, hashtag Chaos Top 10, to pull out meme weapons and trash guns and hear the disbelief from my teammates as I somehow managed to make them work. This is a whole nother community. I know people like this. It's the whole Riot Shield shock charge or Riot Shield ballistic knife. Or you're just going to go find the craziest weapon you can that shouldn't do any good or be viable in any situation, and you make it work. You challenge yourself to go out and go against the meta, go against the overpowered stuff. And that there's a big community that does that. That's actually a really good answer. And that's a good reason why the dedicated medic plays Call of Duty still. Here we go. Next up, Vay. Hope I said that right. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. I still play for the campaign story and the co-op modes like Zombies and Spec Ops. Those have always been the most fun to me. Like I said, back in the Golden Age, those were secondaries. I mean, survival mode, Zombies, Spec Ops, and they were good. They were good support modes for multiplayer. Multiplayer was where it's at. But that's changed. Things are shifting. This year is going to get crazy. We've got COD coming. We've got Battlefield 6 coming. It's going to be a crazy year. I mean, we've got Halo Infinite coming, which could have a battle royale as well. All those focuses are changing, but I agree with you. You got to play the Call of Duty campaign because 99% of the Call of Duty campaigns besides Black Ops 3 have been phenomenal. They're just really consistent. Chaotic Reznov Comrade. The darkness in my soul says because of zombies. Been playing zombies the past 13 years. There is nothing like it. Zombies 15 life. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. Once again, you have those sub-modes, but Zombies is coming to the forefront, and all the leaks and rumors are saying it's going to be its own standalone game and a continuation in the future, which is going to be crazy, but I get it. That's why Reznov still boots up the game. Now, Jay Triple says, Hashtag Chaos Top 10. We all play COD mainly to learn to trash talk, have fun, and let out energy. Well, that doesn't really work anymore unless you're trash talking with the people in your party or your friends, because once again, it's just a different era of matchmaking. But back in the day, you played to... I didn't play to trash talk. I did play to get reactions, but I also played just to listen to the trash talk in the lobby. I'll be real. Nightmare 1987. Simple. Because we are bored and we have nothing better to do. Okay. I guess if you're bored though and you don't have anything better to do, I mean, you can go find something else to do. You could go outside, you could shoot some basketball. You can find something to do, but hey, I guess if you're bored, you play Call of Duty. 1984 by George Orwell. Hashtag Chaos.10, because the gameplay, no matter what, is always fun deep down. We all enjoy the gameplay, even though the games we dislike. I agree. At the core, it's an arcade shooter which just hooks us in, and we all enjoy it. And the final one, I think, Alex Kitch 11, to do our unfinished camo grinds. Of course, you got to have your camo grinds on there. Those will be a thing forever. And there you have it, my friends. Those are reasons why we still play Call of Duty. You let me know your biggest reason in the comment section. Join the Discord, and I'll see you soon.